So we have, if you look at the angle axis representation, you can rotate it by three standard axes, which is all JP, right? All of these are 3 by 3 matrices. Now, based on how you interpret this, there can be three interpretations. First is that it gives you a relation between the transformation is a relation between the original frame and the transform. The original frame and the transform frame. Now, the second thing it can be is, it gives the coordinates or it gives the orientation of the new frame with respect to the original frame. Okay. So you'll have the transformation will not just represent a relation, but it will give you how the new frame is oriented with respect to the previous frame, right? So if you have F0 and F1, with some rotation. So this will be R01, old frame to the new frame. And this not only represents the relation between these two, it will also tell how F1 is oriented with respect to F0. Okay? So that is this interpretation. And then we have a vector interpretation. A vector interpretation means that the matrix is an operator. It is an operator. So if you want to rotate a vector by the same way, you can just multiply the vector by the transformation matrix and you'll have the rotated vector. So if I want, let's say that I have a vector like this. Let me use a different pen. I have a vector B like this and I want to rotate it by the z-axis by an angle of theta. Then I'll take z theta, multiply it by the vector. Okay, vector B, and I'll have the rotated vector, which is, let's say, in this direction, so I'll use a minus angle here. So this will be one. Let's say I want to rotate it by a negative angle, because it's moving in this way. Minus. Okay, so I can rotate a vector using the same matrix. And also, it represents a transformation. It also represents the orientation of the new frame with respect to the previous frame. Okay. Now, let's look at one more thing, as I mentioned to you earlier. We remember these matrices. And we had Z.
The rotation of about the x-axis is not negative sign, just.
X's?
Yeah, you just erase it.
Okay, so we have these three standard rotations, but we don't have a rotation for an arbitrary axis. These are by standard axis, right? These are conventional axis. So this is a rotation along the three conventional axis. What if I want to do a rotation about any arbitrary axis? Defined by a vector k. Okay, so let's say I have a vector k, which is kx times I, ky times j, and kz times k. So this is a vector notation. I, j, k are unit vectors along x, y, and z, right? So let's say that I have this vector like this, and this is my standard frame. This is the vector k. Alright? And I want to rotate about this. I want to rotate the frame about this by an angle theta. Alright? So, let's say that based on this, we can extend this and we can say I drop it into this frame, xy frame here. Okay. And this will be kz. This will be kx. This will be ky. Let's say that this angle here is beta. This angle is alpha. Or let's call this, let me use the notation that the book follows, and which one is alpha or beta. This one, supposedly, is alpha, and this one is beta. It really does not matter because there will be values, but just so that when you look up the book, you're not confused. Let's use whatever is there. Okay. Any idea about how can I accomplish this rotation? If I want to rotate, so basically what I want to do is to have a matrix, right, that I can use thereafter to transform all my rigid bodies from one frame to another frame. So if I want to do a rotation about the axis, so let's write the axis angle notation. I want to do k angle theta, right? This is what I want to find out. Any idea how to do this? How can we accomplish this rotation about an axis k? When I rotate this, basically what we are trying to see is when I have this axis like this, and this is k, when I rotate about k by an angle theta, these axes will change like this, obviously, because I'm rotating it like this, this will go, and this will be like this, right? That will be a rotated frame. So this is, let's say this is F0. My F1 will be centered at the same point, but only thing is it will be rotated. If I have to do that, what I'll do is, there are many approaches. One approach is the following. We'll make one of these three axes coincide with K, do the rotation, and put them back. Okay? So you'll align one of these axes, any one axis of the three standard axes, with K. So one of these, let's say we want to align Z0. So we want to make Z0 come and fall in line exactly with K, do the rotation of theta, then move them back to their original place. So it will require three steps, right? First is to orient any one conventional axis with K. All right. Step two, implement the orientation, the rotation, I'm sorry, of theta by the, along that axis or about that axis. And step three will be undo step one. Okay. So first you'll align one axis with K, implement that orientation or rotation, then undo what you have done here to align it. So this is undo the alignment. Okay. So let's say that I want to align Z with K. What? How do I align Z with K? What rotations do I need to align the Z-axis with K? So first thing what you'll need to do is we'll rotate by this angle alpha. So X will come in this line. So what we'll do is we'll bring X, I'll rotate about this axis by an angle alpha so that X comes here. So when X comes here, so let's do this. Let me do the first step here and then we'll move on to the second step. Okay, this is my friend F0, Z0, and Y0 and X0, right? So first step, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a rotation about Z0 by an angle alpha. Okay? So when I do this, this X0 will come along this line because I've rotated it by alpha. So this will be, actually let me draw the vector first. This is K. This will be X1. So now X is aligned. Once X is aligned, I want to drop Z onto K. So once this has moved here, so for example, this is Z. I have aligned X. X is now in this direction. I want to drop Z. So to do that, which axis will have to rotate by? If I want to bring Z down like this, what axis do I have to rotate by? You have to rotate by the Y axis. Right? If you want to drop this by an angle beta, because you want to drop it down by an angle beta, next thing you have to do is to rotate here by an angle beta so that Z can come. Know that Y is perpendicular into the board. Obviously, I cannot draw it, so you'll have to imagine that this goes into the board. And the rotation will have to be perpendicular to the plane in which you want to move. So if I want to move in this plane, I'll have to rotate by a perpendicular axis. So what I'll do here is, next rotation, I'll rotate by beta, in which case, I'll end up with Z being aligned here. So I'm just going to draw over this. So once I do this, because I'm rotating by y will not change. Y will be exactly where it is. This will be y2. This will be z2. And x will fall down. X will go down like this. Okay. So the second rotation you'll have here is because it's a current axis rotation, you'll write it after this x, v. Alright. So now you have these two aligned. Okay, now you have aligned, this will align z0 with k. You have aligned z0 with k. Let me explain again. First thing what you do is you will move x here like this. Once x has moved here, because y and x are perpendicular, when you rotate by alpha about this axis, y will move within the board and x will come along this line here. So x will be, x0 will be like this. And y0 will go within the board like that. Next thing you want to do is you want to drop z0 onto k. So you'll have to do a rotation about this by an angle beta because you want to drop by this angle beta. So once you do that, you will have z0 aligned here.
So what did you say? R x and beta should be y, no?
I'm sorry, that should be y. Y beta.
Okay.
So you're rotating the second axis by beta. So this will be y beta. Now you can do your rotation along the z axis because this is the current z axis. So here you can implement your rotation as z theta. Okay? All right. Now, to undo the rotation, so r k theta will be equal to first z alpha, then you're rotating by y beta, then you do your rotation, which is z beta. Okay? Now you have to undo this part. Okay? So what we'll do is we'll write it as y minus beta and z minus alpha. Okay? To undo that rotation, this will, to undo this, we'll write it by a minus angle. Okay, this will undo this, and this will be undo. Okay? Now, this is not the only way you can align axis. You can pick to align x-axis, you can choose to align any other axis you want, not necessarily the z-axis. I have chosen here to do the z-axis. Now you can, from here, you can always fill up these matrices with the standard rotation matrix. So now you have everything in terms of standard matrices. So an arbitrary axis rotation about a given new axis can be represented in terms of standard axis by doing like this, by moving one of the frames. So you can plug in these values or these matrices here, and you can get a complete rotation matrix, which refers to a rotation about a new axis. Obviously, these angles have to be found out from the vector. So if you have a vector like this, okay, you can plot this, take the tan of the angle x over y, the same thing that we do, get from here this, which is square root of kx squared plus ky squared, and divide by this hypotenuse, and you can find out that angle. Okay, tan inverse. Is there any way I can align z much easier? If you look at the diagram, can I align, instead of doing two rotations, can I align it by one rotation?
By putting the z by beta angle.
You cannot rotate z by a beta angle because z has to be rotated. How can you rotate z? By which axis do you want to rotate?
Why?
Okay, if I rotate my y like this, then these two will move forward like this, right?
Another arbitrary axis. Another arbitrary axis.
No.
No. X.
Yeah, you can do x. If you do x, this is what will happen, right? So this axis is y. This is y, x, and z. And this is my arbitrary vector. If I rotate by x, this will move backwards, right? It will move backwards. It will come like this. You'll see that y, z is moving like this, but it's actually, there is still an angle between them because this is oriented outwards from the board, and that z will move within the plane of the board, so it will coincide behind it, okay? So you will need two rotations. You cannot do it by one single rotation, but it's up to you, however you want to do it. If you want to do it by x, then you'll have to go by minus beta about this. But if you want to start by z, it's up to you. So if you are rotating with your thumb in the direction of the axis, it's plus. If you want to rotate, for example, if this is my axis, if I'm rotating like this is a positive theta rotation. If I want to rotate opposite to this like this, then it's a negative rotation. It does not matter whether you do a positive or a negative, because here we are undoing it. So if you have a negative angle here, you'll do a positive to undo it, okay? So when you're undoing, just change the sign of the angle. Keep the axis safe. We spoke about one more thing. We spoke about current axis rotations and fixed axis rotations. So as opposed to a fixed axis rotation. Current axis rotation, you always keep on rotating by the current axis. Here, in the case of this, you post multiply. Right? Okay. So, if you have your rotation matrix, this can be R01, the next is 12, this is 0 to n, this will be R23, and so on up to Rn. Right? This can be
handled.
Okay, you'll fill that in. So current axis is always post-multiplied. You go on multiplying to the right. That means you're multiplying with the next axis that you generate from the previous rotation. In the case of a fixed axis, it's pre-multiplication. Pre-multiplication. So here R0n will be equal to, you start from this R01, R12, okay. So you move in the left direction like this, pre-multiplying the rotations like this. And obviously you will have a composite of these two. So that brings us to a discussion of representing an orientation in 3D space. When you have these two conventions, basically it causes a confusion. When I give you an angle like this, an orientation, like this, by three angles as we know, which is phi, theta, and psi. You want to create a rotation matrix R based on these three angles. Okay? You want to generate a rotation matrix that represents these angles, or it represents the posture of a body in 3D space defined by these three angles. Now it causes a confusion if should I pre-multiply them or post-multiply them, okay? So there are two representations. Euler, okay, Euler angles. So these can be Euler angles. Or you have RPY, which is a fixed axis representation. RPY is role pitch angle. Role pitch angle. So Euler angles are, this is a current axis. This is a fixed axis representation. Okay. Let's talk about Euler and then we'll go to fixed axis representation. All right. So when you have Euler angles is a repeated rotation about one given axis. There are 16 different types. Sometimes you have YZY, XYX, and so on, depending upon the convention. But in robotics, we use a standard, which is ZYZ. Okay? So we'll use Euler angles, defined by the rotation ZYZ. Okay? So you'll do a rotation twice about the z-axis, only once about the y-axis. So zyz, this is a current axis rotation. So R Euler will be equal to, so first you'll have, let me list out the rotations. One, phi, theta, and psi. So, rotation of phi about the axis, okay, followed by a rotation of theta about y-axis, and finally again you'll have a rotation of psi about current z-axis. Okay, so when you have these three rotations, you write this as z. First rotation is p multiplied by y, which is theta, and multiplied by z, which is, because they are all in current, this is your first rotation, second rotation, third rotation. So you move in this direction, 1 times 2 times 3. Okay. All of them are current rotations. So let's take the frame and see how. So let's say that I have, this is X naught. So we have phi about z. So when I do this, you will have this thing, x1, y1, and z1 will be here. The next rotation is about the y-axis. So about y, we rotate. I'm rotating like this, right? Because this is the positive angle of rotation. So when I do this, I'll have and then we have the third rotation about the current z-axis by phi. So this will be the rotation about phi. This will be the third rotation. So z3 will also be here because I'm rotating about this. And when I do this, this will be here. We can populate these matrices. I'll give you the eventual rotation. So R Euler, right, when you multiply the three standard matrices, I'm just going to write it. You can obviously, it's not really important, but I'll need that to do an inverse Euler, because once the Euler matrix is given, you should be able to find out the Euler angles. So let me write this for you, and then we'll use it in the next class to do inverse Euler. Cos theta.